हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन न्यूनेटोलॉजी एंड दैट इज पेरीनेटल एस्फिक्सिया. सो फर्स्टली लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ पेरीनेटल एस्फिक्सिया. इट इज डिफाइंड एज द इंसल्ट टू अ फीटस ऑफ और न्यू बॉर्न ड्यू टू द डिक्रीज इन द ऑक्सीजन लीडिंग टू हाइपोक्सिया और बिकॉज ऑफ द डिक्रीज इन द परफ्यूजन दैट इज इस्कीमिया. सो एनी इंसल्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दीज टू रीजन्स इज नोन एज पेरीनेटल एस्फिक्सिया. ओके, नाउ इन ऑर्डर टू लेबल आर न्यूनेट एज पेरीनेटल एस्फिक्सिया अलॉट नंबर ऑफ डेफिनेशंस आर देयर. सो नंबर फर्स्ट इज द WHO डेफिनेशन, दैट इज द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डेफिनेशन. इट डिफाइंस पेरीनेटल एस्फिक्सिया इज फेलियर टू इनिशिएट एंड सस्टेन ब्रीदिंग. ओके, नंबर सेकेंड इज NNPD डेफिनेशन. सो NNPD इज नेशनल न्यूनेटल पेरीनेटल डाटाबेस. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू इट द पेरीनेटल एस्फिक्सिया इज डिवाइडेड इनटू मॉडरेट एस्फिक्सिया एंड सीवियर एस्फिक्सिया. सो मॉडरेट पेरीनेटल एस्फिक्सिया इज स्लो और गैस्पिंग रेस्पिरेशन और द एपगार स्कोर्स ऑफ 4 to 6 एट 1 minute ऑफ एज. ओके, the severe perinatal asphyxia is no breathing or the apgar scores of 0 to 3 at 1 minute of age. So this is moderate and severe perinatal asphyxia according to the NNPD definition, and MCQs are being asked about it. Okay, number third is American Academy of Pediatrics definition. So according to the American Academy of Pediatrics, the perinatal asphyxia is defined as there should be presence of the 4 features. Number first is there is profound metabolic acidosis in umbilical cord blood sample. So the pH in the umbilical cord blood should be less than 7. Okay. Number second is the low apgar scores of less than 3 at more than 5 minutes of age. Number third is there should be evidence of neurological dysfunction, which can be in the form of seizures or in the form of neonatal hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. And number fourth is there should be evidence of multiple organ involvement should be there. That is multiple organ dysfunction should be there. Okay, so these are the important definitions of perinatal asphyxia, and MCQs are being asked about these definitions. So you should be knowing about these definitions. Now let's talk about the etiology of perinatal asphyxia. Okay, the most important and strongest predictor is the antenatal factors. So the antenatal factors are, number first is the placental abnormalities, substance abuse by the mother in the antenatal period like alcohol, cocaine, or the maternal problems leading to decreased oxygenation like the maternal cardiac disease, or the other problems like there can be maternal diabetes, preeclampsia, eclampsia, maternal congestive cardiac failure. Okay, so all these factors leads to, predisposes the child to perinatal asphyxia. Number second is the intrapartum factors, which includes the traumatic delivery, or there can be abruptio placentae or placenta previa can be there leading to bleeding. Okay, or there can be the problems of the abnormal maternal oxygenation like pulmonary edema in the mother. Okay, so these all are the, or maternal hemodynamic problems leading to shock. So these are all the intrapartum factors leading to perinatal asphyxia. And number third is the perinatal factors, in which ischemia or the hypoxia in the fetus. Okay, so these all are the important risk factors that leads to the perinatal asphyxia. Now, what are the consequences of perinatal asphyxia? Number first is a state of primary apnea. So as soon as there is decrease in the oxygen levels or there will be decrease in the blood supply, the first thing that happens is the primary apnea. So in primary apnea, what happens is, it's also known as the blue apnea. There's acrocyanosis is present. The heart rate will be only slightly decreased. The blood pressure and the muscle tone of the baby remains normal. And this type of child responds to the tactile stimulation at the time of neonatal resuscitation. Okay. If the stage of hypoxia or the ischemia prolongs, then the newborn enters into the state of secondary apnea. Okay, in secondary apnea, there will be decrease in the heart rate, the blood pressure will decrease and the muscle tone will decrease. Now, these are the newborns who don't respond to tactile stimulus, but they need positive pressure ventilation at the time of neonatal resuscitation. And then the further outcome of the newborn depends upon how prolonged the state of hypoxia or the ischemia remains in the neonate. Also, there is the problem with the multiple organs. So, multiple organ involvement leads to, like, CNS involvement leads to seizures, encephalopathy, cardiac involvement leads to myocardial ischemia, subcutaneous fat necrosis is there. Okay, in the hematological, there can be thrombocytopenia. In the renal, there is acute renal failure. Okay, so these all are the manifestations of multiple organ involvement. Students, in the clinical feature, when we talk about the part of brain involved in the cases of term babies and preterm babies, it's very important to note that in term babies, there is involvement of the parasagittal area of the brain. And because of the parasagittal area involvement, the upper limb involvement is more than the lower limb involvement, and these neonates suffer through the spastic quadriparesis. Okay. Similarly, a perinatal asphyxia in the preterm neonate leads to the involvement of the periventricular area. So the lower limb involvement is more in this case, and it leads to spastic diaplegia in this neonates, and the MRI picture is that of periventricular leukomalacia. Next important point to remember is Sarnath and Sarnath staging. So this staging is done in order to stage the neonate suffering from the hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. And we talk about the term neonates in this staging. Okay, so stage 1 is only least affected, and stage 3 is severely affected neonates. Okay, now the important points to remember in Sarnath and Sarnath staging is the firstly about the Moro's reflex. The Moro's reflex is exaggerated in stage 1 of Sarnath and Sarnath staging, and it is depressed in 2 and absent in stage 3. In stage 1, there is activation of the sympathetic system in the neonate, which leads to the features of midriasis, tachycardia, there will be decreased bronchial secretions. Okay. In stage 2, there is parasympathetic stimulation leading to meiosis, leading to bradycardia, which leads to there is increase in the secretions, increase in the GI motility leads to diarrhea. And in stage 3, there is depression of both the systems, that is sympathetic and parasympathetic system. Okay, next important point is the seizures are seen in stage 2 of HIE Sarnath and Sarnath staging. Okay, in stage 3, there is decerebrate posturing. And next important point to remember is the outcome. In stage 1, 100% neonates turns to be normal. In stage 2, what happens is the 80% are normal, and the remaining 20%, in which the signs and symptoms persist for more than 5 to 7 days, they have a poor neurodevelopmental outcome. And in stage 3, the 50% of the neonates die, and remaining 50% has lifelong poor neurodevelopmental sequelae. Okay, so this is about the Sarnath and Sarnath staging. Students, when we talk about the diagnosis of hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, the best modality, investigation modality to be done in the cases of the term babies is diffusion wade MRI, which should be done within 3 to 5 days of life in order to see the acute event. In the preterms, the modality of choice is ultrasound. Okay. Now, amplitude integrated electroencephalography. Okay, so in this case, it is used to determine the infants that are at highest risk for developmental sequelae of neonatal perinatal injury. Okay, and the best modality to diagnose the seizures is the conventional EEG only. Okay, now for the treatment part, after being given all the supportive care to the baby, the treatment that you have to remember that is specifically used for perinatal asphyxia is the therapeutic hypothermia. This is done by two techniques. There is head cooling technique and systemic cooling technique. So we in this, the newborn's temperature is to be brought to 33.5 degrees Celsius in first 6 hours of life, and it should persist for 72 hours of life. Okay, so this is about the therapeutic hypothermia, which helps in a normal or a better neurodevelopmental outcome in these children. Okay, and for the seizure management, the drug of choice is phenobarbital. So this is all about the management of perinatal asphyxia. I hope now you'll be able to answer a lot number of questions about the perinatal asphyxia. Thank you, students.